What's going on, YouTube? Team GCL back with another pickup video. Thanks for tuning in today. I got the GoPro back, so hopefully the video quality is a lot better than the last couple videos were with the cell phone. Again, that also goes for the audio. I decided to stay here in my NES area to do the pickup video today. And it's a smaller one, but again, I'm trying to keep to the 1 week of videos so I don't sort of build up with these super long ones. If you haven't already subscribed, please make sure you hit the subscribe button over here. And I'm getting really close to 150. And then once we get to 200, I'll be doing that $50 game giveaway for all the awesome subscribers that I have. Hit the like button if you see any content here you like today. And please leave a comment. I love to chat about anything retro, anything video game. If you see a pickup that you maybe had as a kid, or maybe it's something you're interested in trading with me, you know, definitely give me a shout. I'm totally down for doing that. So as usual with the videos, we will start with non-video game pickups, and I have quite a bit this week. We're going to start with books today. Now, I was at a flea market this week. They had a pop-up flea market at our local racetrack, and the there were a few video game sellers there. There were also some random people who had video games, which is what I was looking for. So this gentleman had these two books here. These are record books. I had some last week as well, but these ones are Pac-Man ones. So this first one here is Baby Pac-Man. Goes to the market. And it actually has the record in the book there. It's in decent shape. Ooh, sliding out, but I got it. And the other one he had was Pac-Man Picnic. And again, he had the, it's got the record right in it there. He was asking $5 a piece, but I bundled this together with something else you'll see later in the video game pickup. So these were actually $2.50 a piece, much more reasonable than $5 a piece. A friend of mine, Steven, was there, and he had his booth set up, and he had some Garfield books, and I actually don't own these two. So the first one is Garfield, the Unabridged, Uncensored, and Unbelievable. It's $2, which is a great deal for these Garfield books. If you've been following my channel, you know I'm a huge Garfield fan. And finally, Garfield Worldwide. So this one's actually a little thicker. Interested to see. Yeah, these ones are black and white. So, but either way, still really cool comics. Love to read them with kids and with even just for my own pleasure reading. Sometimes it's good just to read some boring, sorry, not too intense stuff. Just lighthearted comedy. The last book I found at Value Village, it was considered a kid's book, so it was $1. And that's Garfield Ghost Stories. It's actually from 1978. It's actually an old book. Definitely really cool to check it out, and I'll be reading it with my kids as soon as I get a chance. Okay, I had two color form sets this week. If you don't know, I do collect color form sets. They are very cool. I was at this flea market, and the first one I saw in a bin of board games, and the guy I was asking $5 on it. Normally, I don't like to pay that for these, but this one I couldn't pass it up, and you'll see why right away. This is the Snoopy and Woodstock color form set. It's in mint condition. Like, this box looks immaculate. And then on the inside, it doesn't even look like the pieces have ever been played with. So they're still, like, on the original felt. And it even has the instruction manual, which almost never comes with these things. So very, very cool to see this one. You know, if you follow my channel, I love anything Peanuts related. And in this great shape, I was happy to add this one to my color form collection. The next color form set was at Value Village. Same day we went over there. This one was $2.99. See it right there. And this is the Barbie's Dreamhouse color form set. Now, I'm not a Barbie fan. These ones, I do hold some value on eBay, so I'm probably going to put this one up for sale, considering it was $3. Now, I actually had a $2 off coupon, so I bought something else, because you have to spend over $5, so I got a $1 off each one. So this one was technically $1.99, and it's in good condition, too. So there you go. Last pickups for non-video games are board games, and I got three this week. Two of them were at the antique sale in a random box. The guy wanted $5 a piece, which was totally reasonable for the two board games here. Now, the first one is the box is in very, very poor condition. This is the Amazing Spider-Man and the Fantastic Four, 1977. Very cool board game, very bad condition. The corners are all ripped and flayed. I asked him, I said, do you know if it's complete? He said, I don't know, but I don't think so. And he was right. This game is missing the playing pieces. They're generic. Like, they're not, like, custom playing pieces, so I could replace them. And it was missing some cards, unfortunately. But, I mean, it still looks cool to have in the collection. So, yeah, there's Spider-Man. The next one he had, which was also $5, was a game called SWAT. Get the camera there. SWAT. Now, this game is complete, except for the instructions. But a lot of these older Milton Bradley games didn't have the instructions because they were printed right on the back, so it may not have even had instructions. For $5, I'll add it to the collection. And lastly, for board games, this one was at Value Village. It was $3.99, but we had the $2 off, so this was actually, I knocked a dollar off of it. It was $2.99. This is Monopoly Fortnite Edition. I got this more for my son than for me. The game is 100% complete. It's actually still, most of the pieces are unpunched. They don't hold a ton of value, but I got it more for him than for me. And if he doesn't end up playing it, we'll just resell it. It looks very different than regular Monopoly, but we may give it a try. I actually lied. I do have one more non-video game pickup. This was a Value Village pickup. I had a $2 off coupon. This one was $5.99, but I got it for $2 off, so it was $3.99. And this is a really cool Star Wars Return of the Jedi speeder bike model set. So this was very cool. I saw this sitting there, and I grabbed it right away. The really cool thing about this one is the parts are all 100% sealed. So, like, they've never been used. While the box has been opened, the parts are all unpunched. So this is totally cool. I'm most likely going to sell or trade this because I don't really collect Star Wars stuff, but definitely cool to find for the price that it was. For non-video game pickups, that's it this week, guys. So we're jumping in now to video game pickups. Again, remember to hit that subscribe button if you're just tuning in, and hit that like button as well if you like any of the stuff you've seen so far. So let's get into video games. The first two games, I think I mentioned this a few videos ago, that I'm really looking to beef up my Game Gear collection. And one of my friends just recently decided to sell all of his off, and he's doing it on consignment through my buddy Rick at Retro Bomb Collectibles at the flea market. So I picked up these this week. First one is Aladdin, not a common game, but $5, why not? And the next one, another common game, but again, $5, Jurassic Park. So each one of these was $5. Happy to add these to the collection. Last week I got Autofonts and Garfield from the same seller for $5. It's funny because I was looking around the flea market and I was going to some of the older resellers there looking at their booths, and they had a lot of Game Gear games. And again, I wasn't really looking for Game Gear before, but man, they had like some of them were like $20 for like Aladdin. It was crazy. So it's nice to see that I can still get them cheap. At the flea market, at the big one we went to, this guy had a whole stack of Atari games, $2 a piece. I had them all, except for this one, which actually is for the 7800, and it's Pole Position 2, the Atari 7800. Got it for $2. For $2, I'll add it to the collection. I don't own an Atari 7800. It's one of the consoles I'm still looking for. So if you have an Atari 7800 that you're willing to trade or sell, I'm looking to pick one up. There was a guy on Kijiji Facebook Marketplace, who had some Super Nintendo games, pretty big lot. He was asking $5 a piece. I messaged him for these three. He said, sorry, the whole lot sold. 2 weeks later, he gets back to me and says, the guy fell through, so if you want them, they're yours. So I got all these for $5 a pop. The first one is Super Off-Road the Baja. These are all filler titles for me. This, you know, I'm at the point now with my Super Nintendo collection where I have all the games I want, so I'm just sort of filling in some random stuff. My shelf holds about 120 games, and I think I have 80 now, so I just want to fill it up and then end it off with there. The next one is Home Alone. Never played this one, but seeing many reviews, it doesn't look great. And the last one, of course, any kid knows this one. This is Mortal Kombat. The original one. I'm so shocked they didn't have this one, to be honest with you. So, and you know, I've been seeing them sell for like $15, so $5 was a good deal. So, again, three Super Nintendo games added to the collection. Okay. I found this at Value Village. They had it marked as a magazine, so it was 99 cents. And this is the Pokemon Sapphire and Ruby Red Strategy Guide. I got this for $1. These are really easy to resell. I've had no problems reselling these at conventions, so that's probably what I'll do because I don't play Pokemon games. Very, very unusual to add two Wii games to the collection locally, but there was a woman on Kijiji selling both of these games. They were $5 a piece, and at this point, I'm willing to pay that. I didn't look at the condition because the picture was kind of blurry, but when I got to her house, the house really smelled like cigarettes, which isn't a deal breaker for me, but these had like a layer of grime on them. It was gross. I really shouldn't have bought them, but I was already there and I needed them both. One of them is kind of uncommon, so I tried to clean them up. I switched the cases, but yeah, I shouldn't have done that. The first one is Family Game Show. It was $5, and really shocked I didn't have this one. It is complete in the case, so this is one I guarantee you I won't be playing, but either way, add it to the collection. This one is uncommon, that's why I was happy to pick it up. It's also the last Hasbro game that I need, and this is Hasbro Family Game Night Fun Pack, which is just a combination of what appears to be 2 and 3 Hasbro Family Game Nights, and it's complete in the case. So kind of uncommon. It was the last one I needed. I've never seen it. So not worth a lot, but just harder to find. So pick that one up for the collection. The last pickup was an unusual one. And this was also at the flea market. It just fell out of the box, so I'm just going to show you the box because you don't really need to see the rest. And this is a Gamatic 7600. This is a Pong console, and it's in immaculate condition with the power adapter included. The guy who had the Pac-Man books had this. He was asking $15, so I got this for $15. Only one sold listing online, pretty decent amount. And again, I like these Pong consoles if they have the boxes, and the price was reasonable. I didn't spend a lot this week, so happy to add that to the collection. Otherwise, guys, that's it for my pickups this week. Once again, thanks for tuning in. I will post the total value and what I spent here at the bottom. And again, if you have not hit that subscribe button, please hit it, as I'm really looking to get up to 200 subscribers. And again, hit a like button or comment on anything you want to see or hear or anything you liked, which would be fantastic.